Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and add that function to our program here. And actually, this one works verbatim, just like out of the quiz. Now, if we give it a list of points, it will return the URL for the image. And let's go ahead and use that. If we have any coordinates, make a URL image. We've already implemented that function. Let's go ahead and move our comment. And now we just need to display the image URL. Actually, we need to make one little change here. Image URL equals none. It by default doesn't exist. And if we actually have some points, we can set it to something else. And then we just need to pass image URL into our template. Image URL equals image URL. And now we just need to update our template. And we're going to insert our image. Remember, this is our template. I had a bunch of CSS. Remember, I explained that kind of controls the layout of things. And then we have all of our HTML. And here's our form. And we want to display this to the right of our form. I'm going to do some things you haven't seen before in terms of getting it to display right. But first, let's just get the image in here. If image URL, so basically if it's not none, include our image. And this is how we do that in the Jenga template language. Again, I know we haven't covered this in this class, but it's fairly straightforward. You just have some text, and you have these little escapes for actually running Python code. If the URL is there, include this image. And let's give this a whirl. I reloaded the page, and you can see below the form, we have an image with a marker on it. Pretty cool, huh? Let's get our image displayed off to the right here. I'm just going to go ahead and do that, and I'll explain briefly how it's done. Okay, so I've moved the image over here. I'll show you briefly what I did to do that. I added a class to map so I can refer to it in my CSS. You can use this notion of position absolute, which allows you to position something anywhere on the page. So I positioned absolute, the map, to be 0 pixels from the right and 112 pixels from the top. 0 from the right, 112 from the top. It fits perfectly. Obviously, I knew the size of the image beforehand when we did this whole URL thing. Let's see if our program works. Remember, we've got this hack in here forcing our IP. We're going to have to, probably if we're going to develop this long term, maybe when it's in debug mode, it'll choose from some random IPs or something like that. But when we put it in production, it's going to use the real IP. Right now, we're just going to hard code some IPs so this actually works in the demo. Okay, I'll go ahead and include Udacity's office IP, and we'll submit some ASCII art. We'll have this IP, and let's make sure things work. Let's add a picture of a rabbit. We'll paste that in. Or we'll drop a hand, whichever you're faster at. And we submit this. Ta-da! It took a little longer to submit because we had to look up the IP. But now we can see that we used our office IP, which is down here in Palo Alto. And we have our old IP from that other IP we faked, which is in here in the Colorado. And we can see our rabbit and our cat. And our camel didn't have a location. And so now ASCII-CHAN is much more worldly. And I'll put this online at ASCII-CHAN.com, and you all can submit all the ASCII art you'd love to do. We'll see how this map goes. That's it for this lesson. I hope you learned something about how to interact with other websites. Good luck on the homeworks.